Imagine it's Monday morning. Thousands of people in your city hurry to work and school. However, on this day, terrorists have released anthrax spores in the subway system. Tens of thousands of lives may be endangered. It will take several days of investigating before officials pinpoint exactly who has been exposed. But because it is an anthrax attack, public health officials must act quickly. Many lives can be saved if people start taking medication within 48 hours of exposure. Until officials determined who was most likely exposed to the anthrax spores, public health officials plan to provide medication to everyone in the community. Your local public health agency has been planning for such a scenario by working with state and federal officials in preparing to receive life-saving medications from the Strategic National Stockpile, the nation's largest federal repository of medicines and medical supplies. When requested or as directed, the Strategic National Stockpile has the ability to get medication to several large cities at the same time to support state and local response to an emergency. If there is a public health emergency in your area, your local health department has a plan to help you and your family receive these important medicines. Health officials will open public sites to provide medications to protect the people in your community. These sites are sometimes called points of dispensing, or pods. Pods will be located within your community in safe, familiar places, such as schools or convention centers. When pods need to be opened, their locations will be announced by your public health or emergency management personnel. In an emergency, you can find out where pods are located and what to bring to the pods by watching your local TV stations, listening to the radio, reading the newspaper, checking your local health department's website, or word of mouth from trusted community leaders. These sources of information will also provide you with details about the emergency and symptoms exposed people may experience. If you have any of the listed symptoms, you should see your doctor or go to a hospital and get medicines for treatment. Pods will contain medicine to prevent you from getting sick, but not to treat you if you already have symptoms. Since pods will be used to provide medication to a large amount of people in a short time period, the process at the pod is designed to be simple. You will be asked to fill out a form that includes some basic information about your medical history. Once you have completed your form, a trained pod staff member will review it and determine which medication is best for you. In some cases, you may be able to pick up medications for your entire household, including your children. So make sure you bring information on your family's medical history, including your children's weights. This will ensure you get the proper medications. Also at the pod, you will receive information about the medicine and a number you can call to ask any additional questions. Although the process is designed to be simple and quick, there will be a large number of people at the pods. Please be patient as you wait. Pod staff will do everything possible to get medication to everyone. We hope there is never a public health emergency that requires pods to open, but if there is, be assured the process is in place to get medicine to you and your family as quickly as possible.